Hello everyone, my name is PythonGB and welcome back to another episode of my Terraria Warrior Playthrough. In this episode, the ultimate goal is to go back down into the underground jungle, find a Plantera bulb, destroy it, and then attempt to destroy Plantera. And I'm not going to lie to you guys, I'm kind of nervous about this because I don't think I've ever taken the Plantera boss down with a melee weapon. Well, apart from the Scourge of the Corrupted, but obviously, you know, you can't really get that without happening to get a key from Plantera himself first, so... I don't know, man. I'm hoping my Terra Blade will be enough to take him down, but, you know, time will tell, my friends. Time will indeed tell. So, there are a few things I want to do in preparation before we do that. So, let's go ahead and grab 7 gold. And a bunch of you guys were saying that I should go ahead and brew some ichor flasks. And how you do that is you grab an imbuing station, like so. Do we have any space? Spacey. Is that... Nope, that's no space. No space for me! Okay, we'll have to do it in this house over here. Alright, Mr. Wizard, you've got an imbuing station. What do you think of that? There we go. Look at this, flask of ichor. Ooh. Melee attacks decrease enemies' defense. That is a fantastic stat to have. Let's be honest right here. That's like one of the best things you can have. Oh, here we go. We've got 4 of them. So, how do I consume it? Do I just press the B button? Is it just a normal buff? I would assume so. I've never actually made the flasks before. Like, never in the entire time of playing Terraria, sorry. Never made it. And hopefully it should do me a good job of surviving, I guess. Right, okay. So, in preparation, what I've got is I've got an Orichalcum Anvil. I've got my Turtle Armor right here. We're going to try and get the rest of the Turtle Armor before we try to take down the Plantera boss, obviously. So, that's going to be great. And in order to aid me with that, what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to head to my castle really quick. I'm going to grab a Battle Potion. That should increase the spawn rate of all of the mobs, which is cool. I kind of need that. Something else I might need is an Iron Skin Potion. And as you can see below me, I've actually gone ahead and once again took you guys' suggestions. I put the plants inside pots. So basically, if I do this, it won't destroy the plants, which is pretty damn cool. It will only harvest if I use a pickaxe on it. At least I believe that's how it works. Right, now then. Daybloom. That is what I need. I need Daybloom, iron, and one of these. And I should be able to make an iron skin potion. I can indeed. Good stuff. The only thing is, I only have 1 Daybloom, so I've only got 1 iron skin potion. But it does last 5 minutes. I don't anticipate the fight lasting longer than 5 minutes. It doesn't normally, so I don't know. I should be able to get away with it. I hope, anyway. Oh, man. Right, and of course the reason why I've got this Orichalcum Anvil is just so I can go ahead and make the Turtle Armor as and when I need to, so that's great. In fact, no, hold on a sec, I need to bring the Chlorophyte Bars down with me, don't I? Yes, that would be a good idea, wouldn't it? Right, let's grab them. Pretty sure we don't need the I-Core right now, so we're going to put them away. Right, I think we're just about ready to go. I've got blocks just in case. I should probably take bombs, shouldn't I? To clear out areas quicker. I'll tell you what, here we go. Let's just grab these. There we go. 43 of them. That's a pretty nice amount. And without further ado, let us go into the jungle biome. And we are going to start poning some turtle dudes. So I shall see you guys in the underground jungle. Whoa! Okay. I didn't realize there was a Plantera's bulb right here. This is really high up, actually, for a Plantera's bulb. God damn. I was looking at one that was way down here somewhere. Well, hang on, where is it on the map? There we are, there's a Plantera's bulb right down there where this pink square is. I didn't realise there was one really close to the surface, so that's pretty damn cool. And without further ado, we are going to use our battle potion, and we are going to await the arrival of turtles. That is all. We're going to try and get some turtle shells. We, of course, only need 2 at this point, so it shouldn't be too difficult, depending on if the game's going to be mean to me or not. That is the ultimate deciding factor, of course. Alright. Hello! Oh, Mr. Turtle. My god, that is a big drop. That is a big-ass drop. Hello. Oh, there's a turtle. He just randomly fell down. Hello. How are you doing? Turtle shell? Oh, a mimic! Cross necklace. Not exactly what I need. I've now got 3 of them damn things. Oh, man, there once was a time. Well, I wanted one of them so badly, and now I'm just like, nope, don't need it. I don't need it. Stop giving me them. Give me a blooming Philosopher's Stone. That's what I really want to try and get. If I can get the Philosopher's Stone, I can make the Charm of Myths. And with that, I can use my health potions and have life regen be better, I guess. Right, I'll tell you what, just because we're here, just because we can see this, I'm going to grab this chlorophyte ore. Right, of course, this isn't going to be a mining episode. I just thought I'd grab this just because it's here. Alright, and obviously, again, if I find anything else that's worth getting, then I will. Alright, but obviously the goal is to get turtles. Right, okay. How are we going to do this? We've had a lot of time lapses in the recent episodes of my Terraria series. I kind of want to stick with you guys so you can join me along the journey, if you will. Hello, you're dead. Lol. Stinger. Stinger. And what are these things? Great, okay, I really need them. Bloomin' life crystal. Worthless! Don't need it! Don't need it! Hi, how are you doing, Mr. Dude? Your name's Mr. Dude. That is all you need to be known as. Are you for real right now? I've got increased enemy spawn rates, and there is nobody around here. Are you sure that it increases spawn rates? Because I feel like, for me, what it's actually doing is decreasing the spawn rates. Hello? Where did you go? Please give me your turtle shell. Nope, okay. Well, screw you then. No one likes you. No one likes you. Ooh, life root. Thank you very much. 445 health. Every bit of health is very useful. Ooh! Another cross necklace. Are you for real right now? So we're pretty much getting every single other thing apart from turtles and turtle shells. Interesting, interesting. That's how it's going to work, is it? That is how it's going to work? I don't like that, man. I don't like that. Just give me something that I actually need for once. That'd be great. You know what I'm saying? Hi. So here's my theory. I'm kind of going with if I kill as many mobs as possible, more are going to spawn in its place. So that's kind of why I'm sort of killing every single other mob in the world. Right. Hi. How are you doing? You're dead. Good. Mr. Skelly, how are you doing? You're also going to be dead in a sec. If I can get through it, there we go. Now, one of the things I haven't managed to get so far in this series is a beam sword. And the beam sword is dropped from the armored skeletons, which is pretty cool. Wow, I didn't get a turtle shell from either of them too. Wow. Man, that sucks, man. Hi. What do you think you're doing? What do you think you're doing? Trying to take me down? You think that's actually something you're able to do? You would be quite wrong, sir. Very wrong indeed. Ooh, a campfire. That could be useful. I'm going to go grab that. Didn't even realize I have one down here. Oh, hi. Interesting. Wouldn't it be a major bummer if I managed to get the Uzi for the very first time on this series instead of on my Ranger series? Man, that'd be a right bummer. I've never actually had the Uzi before in the entire time I've played the game. I've never managed to obtain one, which is pretty bad. Oh, a life rod. I didn't even realize there was one there. All right, pretty cool. Pretty cool. Are we going to have to do a jump cut just so we can get into the Plantera action? I feel like we may have to. We have 3 minutes left of this buff, or debuff, whatever the hell you want to class it as. Increased spawn rates, I hardly would class that as a buff, because it doesn't really... I mean, I guess it does help you, but kind of hinders you as well. Gets you killed sometimes, maybe, if you're really lucky or bad at combat. I don't know. Right. I mean, just look at this. There's like every single other mob apart from turtles. This is ridiculous. Why you do this? I am going to go ahead and skip ahead, hopefully, to when we get to having some more turtles to spawn. That made absolutely no sense. I'm going to skip ahead to when I get some more turtles to spawn. That still made no sense. Do you know what? I can't even say sentences today. Doesn't even matter. Let's skip ahead to when we get some more turtles, and I'll see you guys, hopefully, when I've got some. Aha! Turtle shell numero 2! Which means I've only got one more to go until I can complete the turtle armor set. Sweet! I'm liking this. Alright, our battle potion has run out, but we are still able to find turtles, but probably at a slightly slower rate than before. So, once again, guys, gonna skip ahead until we get the third turtle shell needed to complete the set of armor. And I shall meet you guys back, hopefully, when I have got it. Aw, man. Wouldn't it be a funnier thing if I managed to get it right there? Yeah, that's not going to happen, is it? My luck isn't quite there these days, is it? Oh, man. All right, guys. Skipping ahead. Oh, let's go! Finally, a Philosopher's Stone. Sweet. Nice. Not quite a turtle shell, but I'm pretty happy with that. I'll take that. But once again, skipping ahead. Hopefully, we'll get the third turtle shell, ladies and gentlemen. See you in a sec. Hey, there we go. Turtle shell number 3. Let's go. I'm very happy, as you could probably tell by now. Right, oh my god, I've got so much other crap that I need to chuck away there. Oh my god. Banners, I kind of want to keep them because I'm kind of collecting them. Bazaar, got loads of them back at base. Nature's Gift, got loads of them back at base. What else have we got? Heart crystals. Yeah, we could probably sell these. I don't know how much they're worth, to be honest with you. Probably don't need that. Probably don't need that either. Stone, Chlorify, keep that, of course. Alright, let's go ahead and let's chuck down the Orichalcum Anvil. And let's make ourselves the rest of the turtle armor. Oh yeah, here we go. And then the leggings. Bada bing, bada boom. Oh my god. We now have 74 defense. And we basically have a thorns effect permanently. Every time an enemy hits us, they will take damage as well. Fantastic. Very, very useful for the Plantera boss, of course. Oh man, I'm pretty excited now. I'm pretty excited. Am I feeling confident? Half and half? 50%? I don't know. I feel like I should be able to take him down, especially with this absolutely ridiculous Terror Blade. I mean, I really don't see why I shouldn't be able to do it. Wait, hang on. That only does 155 damage. What if I put this back on? 160. Put that back on. 167. Oh. Does the most damage if I don't have the full set. Well, that kind of sucks, but I do like the thorns effect. That's the thing. Alright, 155, and how fast does it go? It's actually significantly slower. Let's just put this back on. Look how fast it is. It does more damage, and it's really freaking fast. And then I put this on. It's slower. Wait, hang on. I'm going the wrong way as well. I'm going completely the wrong direction in order to get back. Right. Let's get up here. Okay, we're getting there. We're getting it. Where is the Plantera ball? It's on this ledge here. Right, okay. Now what we need to do is we need to go ahead and do this. I love doing this. My favorite thing to do in Terraria. Blow stuff up. Oh, yeah, let's go. All right, man. All right. You can't even when I've got these blooming bombs. I mean, like, what are you even trying, man? Stupid idiot. Oh, look at this. Everybody's getting destroyed. I love it. Come on, man. Okay. Oh, there's so many things going on right now. There's like random patches of gravel. Let's turn on auto mine and let's just absolutely go to town on this. There we go. Got a bunch here. Oh my god. This is a really, really open area of jungle. Once I've dug out this little bit, I'm going to show you it on the map. You can probably see it already, but there is a massively, massively dug out bit of jungle. It's not even dug out either. It was naturally like that. It's ridiculous. Right, hold on. I just want to get rid of these bits, and I want these hornets and stuff to go away. Hi, how are you doing? If you could die, that'd be great. I am not dying to you. Not at all. That's not happening. Not happening. Okay. All right, you're dead. Right, I want to cover these up just in case I want to wind up landing somewhere. There we go. All right, we should be pretty good to land if and when we need to. Oh my god. They're not going to stop spawning. As long as this place is open, there is so much space for them to spawn in. That's the problem with having a gigantically large open area. All right, okay. Let's just continue digging this out there. We're nowhere near done. Okay, where are you at? All right, you're dead. Oh, you didn't even do that much damage anyway, to be honest with you. Let's just dig this out over here, just to make it kind of flat, so we don't keep getting caught when we're flying about. Because, you know, there's going to be a lot of flying about, let me tell you. Oh, come on, man. There you go. Ooh, a life fruit. Nice. Didn't even realize that was there. I am grabbing that for sure. And if you didn't notice already, yes, I did manage to find some off camera. So we're up to 470 health now. Very useful once again. Right, okay. Torches, just so you guys can actually see the fight. That'd be great, wouldn't it? Being able to see. Oh, mimic. Hello. Give me your gold. What is it? A jewel hook. Okay. Not like I've already got 30,000 of them already. Oh, boy. Oh, boy. Good lord. Really? Really? Are you really doing this to me right now? Right. Now, I think the only other thing I really need to do is make some sort of platform in the middle just so I can stop flying when I need to. Right. Okay. Here we go. Put it here. Come on. Actually do it. There we go. There we go. Let's put that up here. And health. Oh, God. I'm pressing like 3,000 buttons at the same time in order to try and do what I'm trying to do. It's ridiculous. I feel like doing this isn't the best idea either. Alright, so we've got plenty of space to fly up there, plenty of space to fly down here, although I feel like doing this might be a good idea, right? Yeah, let's do this. Just so we don't wind up falling down too far, if you get what I mean. There we go. Will you please go away? What is wrong with you, man? Okay, here we go. Campfire. Bada bing, bada boom. Do I have any lead? If I had some lead, I'd be able to make some heart lanterns, but obviously not. Alright. So how does this work? Do I have to throw it? Oh, God. Oh, my God. Weapon imbue. I-core. Melee attacks decrease enemy's defense. Oh, that sounds amazing. I want to restore my health back up to max before I do it, and I'd like to do it naturally, just so I can still regen it when I need to. Okay, 380. I'll tell you what. Here we go. Let's just try this thing out. Here we go. If I die, then I die. That's how it works. Oh, hi. How you doing? If you could... Oh, my lord. Okay, she's taken a lot of damage already. Ha! So, you know, the I-Call flask is doing its job. Look at these crits. I just saw 380. Oh, my lord. Oh, my God. Not only will I probably be able to kill this girl or guy... No one's ever known the gender of Plantera, to be honest with you. No, especially not me. I don't know. I just don't know. Okay, regen. All right, iron skin is definitely helping at this point. So, you know, pretty cool. Oh, boy. Now is the tricky bit. We've got all the little grabber dudes we need to contend with. I'm not even using the underside of my platform. All right. 9,000 health. Oh, boy. Oh, got caught. Let's try to avoid getting caught again. Do you know what? I'm pretty confident. I'm confident at this point. I should be able to do this. As long as we don't get hit too many times, we're going to be able to do this for sure. Absolutely for sure. Look at that. What was that? 3,000 health? 2,000? 1,000 health? Oh my god, this guy's dead. This guy's just dead. Oh, let's go. Screams are echoing from the dungeon. Ooh. Oh yeah. Ooh. Right, now where's the second one? The second one is somewhere down here. Where you at, buddy? No. I'm trying to locate the other summoning bulb. My memory has gone to pot, apparently. I am sure it was somewhere around here. There it is. Yeah, it would take a fair amount of traveling, but I think I'd be able to lure Plantera back down. I mean, obviously, we're not allowed to use the grenade launcher, so we're going to have to discard that immediately. But what I can do is I can go ahead and... But what the hell? You're in the wrong place, you idiot. All right. But, yeah, you know, just things spawning in the wrong biomes. That's fantastic. Right. Okay. I'm feeling pretty confident. I should be able to do this. There should be no reason why I can't do this. A second time. We've still got some of our buffs left, which is very nice indeed. Where's the thing? It's right below us. Oh, man, this is going to be quite the hefty journey. Oh, this is going to be a bad journey. This is going to be a bad journey. I'm telling you this right now. If we could do this first time. Oh, my God. Here we go. All we got to do is travel upwards. Right, we've got to try and get her on sight. I'm calling it a her. I don't know why. Wait, where are you? There you are. Right. Get her to grapple all of these places just so she can move towards me. Hello. Come on. Maybe I can get some hits on her while I'm going. Yep, that's cool. And then we're going to try and get her to come back up to the really empty open area of awesomeness. Look at this. 29,000 health. What was that from? Maybe, what, 2-3 hits? Let's keep it going. We're going to go over this direction, back into open area. Intrabid, nature's gift. All right, got a nature's gift from pretty much nowhere. Right. There we go. Oh, wow, somebody drops. All the drops, my friends. Can she not grapple up here? Are you for real right now? Come on, buddy. Look, I'm waiting. I'm waiting very patiently. Don't make me get impatient, because that's not really a good thing to do. Right, come on, grapple over this side. You gonna do that? Please? There she is. Look, she's just flying around. Hello, how are you doing? Here we go. We still got some of our original buffs left, which is cool, but I imagine they're gonna run out at some point, so... That is something we are going to have to consider. We are still pretty much at max health, which is very, very good indeed, of course. All right. And she is almost at half health. Yeah. So, as a percentage, I've got more health than she has. Ha! Sucker. There we go. This is just a stroll in the park for old Warrior PythonGB.
Oh man, I sound so big-headed when I say that. I don't mean to be, I'm sorry.
The Terror Blade just absolutely destroys everything. It's ridiculous. It is a ridiculous weapon. Oh man. I'm excited to see what kind of things they put in the 1.3 update. Apparently, there are some new summoner items coming in 1.3, which is pretty cool. Another grenade launcher? Oh, a pygmy staff. Wait, did we just... What? So we got a grenade launcher and a pygmy staff. Both of them we're not allowed to use because that is a summoning weapon. That would, of course, be useful in the summoner playthrough, but we are not doing the summoner playthrough for now. We're doing warrior. Right. Well, then.
So, you know, this has been an absolute success of an episode. I like this. Full turtle armor. The blooming flasks, which absolutely wrecks everything. So for those of you who suggested that, thank you so much. For those of you who also suggested that I should use clay pots for my little farms, thank you very much for that as well. My God, you guys have been helping me quite a lot, haven't you? You guys are awesome. Oh my God. But I guess on that note, ladies and gentlemen, it is time to end the episode. Thank you so much for watching. If you did enjoy the episode, and of course you want to see more of the series, be sure to hit that thumbs up button. And of course you can subscribe if you want to know when the future videos are out. Obviously in the next episode, what we're most likely going to do is explore the jungle temple. But for now, it is time for me to go. Thank you so much for watching once again. Thank you for your continued support and for your help. And I will see you guys in the next episode.